He showed up one day and he came in with two ukuleles and he gave me one. He goes, "You gotta play this thing. It's great, you know, let's jam, you know." And I said, "I have no idea how to play a ukulele." "It's no problem. I'll show you, you know." So we spent the rest of the day playing ukuleles. And I mean, playing ukuleles, strolling around the yard playing ukulele. My wrist hurt the next day. But he taught me how to play it, you know, and learned the chord formations. And when he was going, I walked out to the car, and he said, "Well, wait, I want to leave some ukuleles here." And he'd already given me one, you know. I said, "Well, I've got it." "No, we may need more." And he opened his trunk, and he had a lot of ukuleles in the trunk. And I think he left four at my house, and he said, "Well, you know, you never know when we might need them, because everybody doesn't carry one around." He and Jeff had kind of pictured this group, the Traveling Wilburys, and George's idea was that he would handpick everybody in the band and it'd be the perfect little band. But I think the qualifications were more about who you could hang out with, you know, more so than like trying to find the best guy that did this or that. Though George liked to surround himself with people that were good at something, you know. George rang my bell one night and came in and said, "God, I just had dinner with Roy Orbison and Jeff, you know. And I got this idea, I've got to do an extra side for a single that I'm bringing out. I need a studio, so I called Bob Dylan." And, you know, Bob had a little studio out at his house, and so he's agreed to let me use the studio. "I'm going to try to write something tonight and we'd do it, but I thought I'd have Roy on it too, and if you want, you know, maybe you'd come too." And I said, "Yeah, well, I'd love to come." Being beat up and battered around, being sent up and I've been shot down. You're the best thing that I've ever found. "What's it going to be called, George? You got to have a name for your song." And there was a packing crate that said "Handle with Care." And I witnessed him look over at the crate and look back and say, "Oh, it's Handle with Care." So we cut the track and then we took a break to eat. And he said, "Okay, well, now we got to write some words, guys. You know, I got these songwriters here. Time to write a song. You know, let's write one, you know." So everyone would just throw a line out and you'd get "no," or, you know, but sometimes a line would come out and go, "Oh, that's good. That's a good, oh, I like that," you know. And so that's how we did it.